Good afternoon, everybody, and thanks for joining us here on the web. A frightening wake-up call for a family on Hampton Beach early this morning. Take a look at this. The damage left behind after a van crashed into their home, and the damage doesn't stop there. Police say a distracted driver is to blame. Melinda Davenport spoke with a resident and neighbors and has more.
Usually at 4 o'clock in the morning, residents in Hampton Beach say all is quiet on the streets of town. But on Friday, they got a rude awakening that neighbors could hear from several streets away.
Just sounded like this huge noise.
Authorities say a Chevy van crashed into this home on Q Street and Ashworth Avenue. That collision was after the van took out a fire hydrant right off the mooring.
Said he went to reach for something that fell. And when he went to reach, obviously so it hit the bottom of the house.
Police say the driver dropped his phone and took his eyes off the road. You can see the damage that followed. Only one person was in the home, Patrice Manley's elderly mother, who has lived in the house since the early 70s.
And I guess it woke up everybody in the neighborhood, the sound, the crash, yeah. So, and she's elderly, so it was tough. She's 91, so.
Luckily, no injuries in this accident, but police say the driver was cited for negligent operation of a motor vehicle. Patrice says the driver was remorseful after the crash.
Well, we all should pay attention, of course, but I've done the same thing. I've leaned down to reach for something and found, oh, gosh. And he was, you know, he was very shaken up, and he was concerned about my mother and that the house. So it's an accident.
Now, the good news here, authorities have told the owner of that home that she will be able to live inside the home while the rebuilding efforts are taking place, despite all of that damage. Manchester police say they are questioning a person in connection to 8 arsons in the Queen City over the last week, including 4 overnight. Firefighters say someone set fire to 4 trash cans overnight, one at the New Hampshire Institute of Arts, the second at 70 Mechanic Street, another behind Bridge Cafe downtown, and the last at 455 Pine Street. Investigators say those fires are connected to 4 arsons last Friday night in the area of Central High School on the east side. Officials are investigating 42 arsons in Manchester already this year. A Salem man has been charged with first-degree murder in connection to a nearly 42-year-old cold case in Massachusetts. 57-year-old Michael Ferreira has been indicted by a grand jury. Back in May, he was also indicted for lying to a grand jury. Investigators say in 1969, he helped 2 other people kidnap 15-year-old John Joseph McCabe of Tewksbury, Massachusetts. Police say the 3 men then assaulted, bound, and gagged McCabe, leaving him in a Lowell field, where he later died. The 2 other men were already charged earlier this year. Well, starting tonight at 5, just as the Patriots get back into action, there is controversy brewing over a photo of Tom Brady's youngest son. The Boston website that posted a picture of the boy naked on a beach and the demand some are making to have it taken down. That does it for us. Have a great weekend, everybody.